combination of pellet and corn is my go-to bait for fishing in the colder months. We're in January now, and this lake I'm fishing on was froze over 2 days ago, and my mate took the temperature that day, and the water temperature was 3 degrees, and it's definitely not climbed any more than that since the weekend. Combination, because what you get if you're fishing it properly with a small pot and you're cupping it in at the right distance every time, you get a small area of bait on the bottom, hopefully no bigger than a dinner plate, but that's just soaked 2mm pellets, and there's never really a day throughout the year where a carp won't eat 2mm pellets. Another reason why I soak the pellets is because they're ready to eat straight away. Once the water goes really cold, I don't think they want to start crunching baits up like in the warmer months when hard pellets, you know, the go-to bait. The reason why corn's so good is it's just a standout bait on top of the dinner plate of 2mm. You can imagine fish just coming browsing over. They're not really hungry, but they might be slightly interested. They see a bit of corn in the middle of the lot smaller pellets, and they'll just take it instantly. The type of pellets I'm using today are the Fin Perfect 2mm pellets. It's a pellet I've been using ever since they were launched, probably 15 years ago now. And I use them right through the year on different styles of fishing. But today I'm using them, I'm soaking them with a lot of water, and that makes them heavy. They've swollen up after the hour or so soaking time, and that makes them heavy. So when I'm potting them in, they're just going straight down in a column of broken up pellets. I think it's a lot better than them sticking together in a ball and potting them in. Sometimes a ball, if it's not perfectly round, then it can track off to one side or the other, and you're tipping pellets, the ball on your float, imagining that your hook bait is over that area, and you might not be. So I've got good faith in that a column of pellets sinking down to the bottom, straight down, and just lowering your hook bait onto the pellet. My pellets for this type of fishing that I'm fishing today is very simple, really, and it's very similar to the way I'd prepare them for a pellet feeder. Not so much the method, where for the method I'd level them with water and wait the hour, and then they're more or less perfect to put on the method. But a pellet feeder, they need a bit more water with them. The more water you put with a 2mm pellet, the less sticky it gets, but the heavier it gets. So when I soak a 2mm pellet for this type of fishing, pole fishing, potting it in quite deep water here today, when I soak the pellets, I'd leave a good half inch of water over the pellets in a bait box, and just let them soak it all up, still the same sort of time, round about an hour. Still want to be quite dry. It's no good them sitting in water, else you can't pack them in your pole pot. So I think it's really important just to get as much water in the pellets as you can, but still them being quite dry on the outside. The way I'm fishing today, corn is just a hook bait. I'm not feeding any. It's just a standout hook bait amongst the bed of pellets that I've got in that small area on the lake bed. it's always worth taking a bit of time when you're selecting a hook bait out of your bait box of corn. What you're really looking for is a nice even shaped piece of corn, quite dark in colour, around about 6 or 8 mil in size. This time of year, then I believe you need to have a long pole in your hands for fishing this method. You'll see the lake's really clear today. For that reason, the fish just move out. Although I've sat into the end of a lake here today, I'm still fishing away from the edge because it's really clear. You can nearly see the bottom in the margins. So for that reason, I'm fishing it out towards the middle of the lake with a long pole, because that's where I believe you can draw fish from the deeper water. It can work anywhere in your peg, even at this time of year, but a lot depends on the depth really and how cold it's been. You can never sort of rule out any area in your peg fishing like this, but this time of year you need to be out. You need, you know, 13 meters minimum. I'd be happier fishing at 16 metres, just so that you're pulling fish from the open water, you know, towards the middle of the lake. But it's equally as well, you know, on makings, I spent fishing there for years, and that was my go-to starting method. If you draw a snake late, then I'm fishing exactly the same as I am today, but up to an island, obviously with a shorter rig and a lighter float, but the principle's the same. You just hooks your rig over to the island, let it settle first, and then you want to be tipping your pellets on top of your float. A lot of anglers do it the other way around. They'd like to tip the pole tip over first and then drop the rig in it, but I like to see the float there sitting fishing, so you've got an area that you can pot onto. The way I'm feeding this peg today is by using a medium-sized soft cad pot. And what I'm doing, I'm just filling the pot up with softened 2 mil pellets and just thumbing them down, not that hard, just so that they stay in the pot, and then shipping it out to the desired position. But what's really important with this, I believe, is to settle your rig in first and get it as if it's fishing right on the area where you intend to fish. And then only then, you turn your pole tip over and then you just immerse your pot on top of your float. It's there as a marker. I'm fishing dead depth, so your corn hook bait is directly under your float. So just turn over your pot, just dip it in on top of your pole float bristle just for a couple of seconds, and the holes inside the soft pot will just let the water in and the bait will fall out, just sinking down in that column of pellets. Fishing this way, accuracy is the most important part of it. The way I've got my pot positioned, it's right on the end of the pole. It's even touching the bush. You know, it's not an inch back. It's right on the end there, which will be, when you lower your rig in, plumb down, then your pot's going to be exactly over your float. As well as that, when I'm fishing at the desired length, I can feel the end of the pole on my elbow. And that's the time when you spin your pole over and tip the bait on your float. As well as that, then today I'm fishing here, there's a rope across the middle of the lake, which stops the anglers throwing over halfway to the lads on the other bank. And there's a float that keeps a rope float that keeps a rope on the surface, and it's not moving. There's a reflection on it as well, so I know that it's not moving, and that is my marker for direction. So if you get them three things and put them together, and then you should be inch perfect every time. But that's not the end of the story. The weather plays an important part with this style of fishing. What you need, and we've got it here today and couldn't really wish for it any better, is a flat, calm, still day. It's easy to fish that way. You can get it super accurate. But if you're supposing that it's a windy day, and you're holding a long pole this time of year to get the fish that are off the bank, it's a windy day, you can be struggling to hold a pole still. And as well as what comes with that is the undertow. Because it's a still day today and it's quite a small pool we're on here at the Glebe, it's not likely to be towing that much, even if it was quite windy. But on the bigger lakes, you know, you get a bit of wind on it and then you start to get tow. And it's imagining where your pellets are landing on the bottom. Hopefully they're falling plumb down, but if there's any tow, then they're going to go one way or the other. So, you know, it's worth experimenting with your rig. Feed on the same position every time, but it's worth dobbing probably a foot, a yard downstream if it's towing, just to find out where most of your bites are coming from. The rig I'm using today is an F1 pellet float. The reason I'm using a float like that is because it's got a stable wire stem, a slim body which makes it stable as well, and it's got a slightly longer, thinner tip than the carp pellet, which is another real favourite float of mine. It's a bit finer, so it's more sensitive, but the length's more important to me. And what I've got it shotted so that most of the bristle is showing. There's none of the body showing, just the full length of the bristle. And the reason for that is because fishing like this, you know, because you're fishing just a tight area on the bottom of the lake, if you get a few fish there, you're going to get quite a few liners. But you don't want to be striking it at liners, because that can be the worst thing. If you foul hook a fish, then it's going to tear off and it just upsets your peg. It might waft a load of pellets about as it takes off, and then you've got to start the process up all over again. So you've got plenty of bowl bristle showing, but it's quite a thin diameter tip, and I'm waiting for a positive bite. It could still be a liner, and there's not a lot you can do about that. But you know, say if you've got like half the bristles showing and you get an indication that's going to go halfway under and then come up again, then you're going to strike at that. But if you've got the full bristle showing, then you need to wait until it all goes under, and then just a steady lift in and hopefully your fish is on. Fishing this way, patience really is a virtue. As I said, the water here today is not much more than 3 degrees, and it's not rising, it's not warm at all. The air temperature is about the same. So it just makes sense that you're not going to go in and get a fish every put in. You know, you can imagine the fish, although they're in that area, they're moving ever so slowly. So for that reason, you're going to be waiting a while between your bites. I've been fishing about 2 hours here today and I've caught 5 carp. Now, you know, that's good going, that is, when it's this cold. But I'm waiting a long time for bites. But as in other styles of fishing, your bite, if your feeding's really accurate, your bite's going to come around about the same time, give and take a minute or two. And that's state of form here today. I've potted my bait in, I'm sitting there patient, and within 10 to 15 minutes, nice bite, sometimes it's an indication, and have got a fish on. So yeah, patience is important. Sometimes, you know, you have to wait an hour or two before you get an indication. Luckily, we've caught one first drop here today, although I've had to wait a while. Likewise, you know, we all know the last hour when the fish start moving, if they're going to move at all this time of year. That's the time when, you know, you can probably, you know, bites will be a bit more frequent.